Fashion Sluts story time. This is about a $75 Spirit flight to Atlanta for a day and a half. It started out for a trip for my little baby Dad's birthday. I think she had about 7 people to fall off, so she ended up canceling it. Black folks always start out with 15 people and it ended up just being you. But hell, me and my sister, we haven't paid $75 for our flight, so we was like, buddy, let's just go eat. I really wanted her to try Frost Bistros, and then I wanted her to try Harold's Chicken and Icebar, you know, the one in Edgewood, they go down. So let's do this quick rundown. First up, you can see by the thumbnail that we flew Spirit. It was a late afternoon flight, about 6:30, which was fine. I took a very small bag, very small, so I didn't have to pay for a carry-on, because hell, I wasn't going to be there alone. But they tried it with me, though, talking about my bag was too big for a personal item. Bitch, please. I went out to the side, did some moving shit around, and I re-measured it. Before I'd have paid $100 at that gate, I'd have went right back home. It's the principle. It's principalities in this shit. I always go to DFW early so I can sit in TGI Fridays and have me a little drinky drink. My waitress was very nice. I'm by myself because my sister always shows up late as hell, like right before takeoff. But it's okay because I'm in zone 4, and if you didn't flew Spirit, you know it's going to take you about another 40 minutes to even sit down. So the flight was pretty quick. It was an hour and a half. I always get the aisle seat because I want to be the first person to get off that bitch. You know, the people by the bathrooms and shit be done ran past you, and all of a sudden you still on there. So no, I have to bogart and get my ass off of there. Other than the big ass man that was sitting next to me, leaned all in my seat. It was pretty cool. We got to the hotel, which was the Marriott across from Lennox Mall. It's very nice and extremely convenient. So we freshened up, put our bags up, and grabbed an Uber to the first stop, which was Harold's Chicken and Icebar in Edgewood. I wouldn't have it no other way. I want to go to the ghetto one. Well, I know that chicken going to be fresh up out that grease. I've been a few times. This would be my sister. This is her first time going, so I wanted her to try to experience it. It was so much fun. We met like some girls from Mississippi. It was their birthday. Then we met this girl from Alabama. She was a nurse. She was so nice. This girl literally walked up to me and my sister and prayed for us. She was just like, she wanted to be one of those women who embraces other women, and she prayed for us to have success in our lives. She prayed for our children, and I've never met a person like that. Hell, people you're around every day, all your life, don't pray for you. But for a stranger to do it, it literally just hits different. So I pray she's listening so that we can reconnect again one day. We tried to get back in touch with her to get her phone. We was like trying to get her phone number, but the hell, they had closed the doors because these crazy bastards had started fighting. Baby, let's go. Bullets and licks ain't got no name. All in all, I would always recommend Harold's Chicken and Icebar in Atlanta, in Edgewood. That chicken is the best I've had in a very long time, and I'm from Louisiana, so what they tell you. I had a Long Island tea, and when I tell you, baby, they don't measure them shots that long, baby. My sister really enjoyed herself to the point where she did not want to leave. I had to keep reminding her, baby, I am sleepy. Don't it turn you up when somebody enjoy the place that you recommend, though? All right, next day, which is Saturday, we get up and get dressed. Oh, I got this shit off. And we went to Frost Bistro. Well, the ambiance is really nice, but I do feel like the aesthetic needs an upgrade. You know, like something to wow the tourists, because I'm pretty sure that's like where the bulk of their customers come from. Our waitress was very nice, but the service is snail slow. So I ordered the creamy grits with salmon, and I added some grilled shrimp. Okay, honesty time. The grits were runny. The creamy ones that you can find in Atlanta that go hard. No, that's not what they were. The salmon was overcooked. It was dry as hell. I had to season it myself because it was way too bland. And anybody that knows me know I never add seasoning to my food because I have like a I can taste spice like by the second. I don't like over seasoned food. So for me to add it, it was not there at all. The margarita was super good, but it was very small, like the size of a Dollar Tree fish bowl, and it was $17. So been there, done that, won't be back. So now back to the room, at least so I thought. This girl made my tired ass walk across the street to the mall. She loves the malls, like she wear them hoes out here in Dallas. I hate them. Hate. I complain so much that we finally went back to the room, took a nap, freshened up for our last restaurant. Okay, so this restaurant was called The Broiler. This girl is obsessed with seafood. They also had amazing service. They truly did. The staff was so friendly, y'all. But anyway, I got a half pound of shrimp with potatoes and corn. It was very hot, like overly hot. Like maybe they even microwaved it, which took the moisture out of the damn shrimp. They were like so tough, and so was the corn. The corn was it was just very crunchy. I ordered a margarita. That bitch had zero alcohol, so I ordered a shot of Don Julio. Even with that shot, it still tasted like some damn Sonic slushy or something. Been there, done there, won't be back. All right, y'all, so that concludes my day and a half trip to Atlanta on a $75 flight. Bye, y'all. She a fashion killer, and I'm a trendy lady.